Hello friends, welcome to the second lecture on powder metallurgy. In this lecture we will discuss about atomization, which is one of the most important techniques to create metallic powders. Atomization is basically a very simple process. Here what we do, we take some molten metal and we convert this molten metal to a spray of droplets, either with the help of air or with the help of some liquid like water. So let us see how this entire thing takes place. Here we have a collecting chamber where our powders will be collected, and this is where this molten metal, suppose I am working with aluminium, so I'll melt my aluminium and I'll keep it here in this collecting tank. And from this is a siphon. This molten metal is sucked into a converging nozzle. Now what happens is that this converging when it reaches here, this molten metal reaches here, from the other end of the nozzle, air will be forced into this nozzle. So what happens when this jet of air strikes this molten metal? As a result, this molten metal will come and collect in the collecting chamber in the form of small powders. In the similar way, in this second setup, it is exactly the same. But this setup is different. Here we have an overhead tank. This is an overhead tank. What happens? We keep our molten metal here in the overhead tank, and this is a converging nozzle. With the help of this nozzle, the molten metal is forced to come out to the collecting chamber. Now we can use either air or gas, noble gas like helium, argon. Why we need to use helium and argon? Because in some cases atmospheric oxygen reacts with molten metal. So if we are working with those metals, then it will be a wise thing to do to use helium or argon in place of air. So this whatever gas we are using, this gas will be injected from these two ends, and when these gases will come and strike this flowing metal again, like what we have seen here, this flowing jet of molten metal will get converted into small droplets. Now here one thing we have to take care is that the velocity of this jet is inversely proportional to the size of the particles. Now if I want small size particles, the velocity of the gases has to be very high. Similarly, if I want bigger size particles, the velocity has to be moderately high. So this is how gas atomization takes place. Now in water atomization, the working principle is same, exactly the same. The only difference is that here, instead of gas or oxygen, we are injecting water. The setup will be same, everything will be same, the working mechanism is same, only the working fluid is different. This is a liquid here. Now in some cases when the jet of water strikes the molten metal, the problems of oxidation takes place. So if we don't want this oxidation to take place, we can use synthetic oil. We can instead of using water, we can go for synthetic oil. Now one advantage of using liquids over gas is that the rate of cooling is very high. When this powder metal gets deposited in the bottom, they gets cooled very fast if we are using the water or oil atomization. And finally, the third mode of atomization is the centrifugal atomization. It is slightly different from what we have studied so far from the two previous two modes. So before trying to understand the working principle of this mode of atomization, let us try to understand what is a centrifugal force. Here you can see a string. Let us suppose this is a string, and a stone is tied to the string, to one end of the string. Now if a certain person, suppose he is moving the string around his head, so radially, so the force which will be acting outward, that is if this is the center of this circle, imaginary circle, the force that will be working away from the outward in the direction of outward direction from the center, this is called centrifugal force. Now here we are taking help of centrifugal force, this logic, to get our metallic powders. What we are doing here, we will have an overhead tank. In this overhead tank, we will pour our molten metal. Now this molten metal, by the action of gravity, this will be allowed to fall at a very high speed through this nozzle, constricting nozzle. And here I have a rotating table. If you can see this symbol means this is rotating. So this will be rotating at a very high speed. So when this molten metal will come and fall here on this table, due to this, since it is moving radially, so this due to the action of centrifugal force, this metal, this molten metal particles will be scattered here and there radially. Now after this, due to this action, this molten metal will get converted into small droplets, and it will collect in the bottom of the collecting chamber. So, and in this way we will get our metallic powders with the help of centrifugal atomization. So this was all about atomization. In our subsequent lectures we will discuss some other techniques of powder metallurgy. So stay tuned and don't forget to subscribe our channel MagVidya. Thank you guys.